In this video, you're going to learn how to find all the words in a number of texts in just one go. So we'll select a project here, and I'll just show you that it actually consists of 456 texts with 28 megabytes worth of data. So we'll take all that. And we'll now select the frequency report, also called the vocabulary report. We're going to compare the words in the documents with a general corpus list, and that is a long, long list of many, many words in the language that we're going to be working with. In this case, it's English. So for that reason, I'm just pointing out the system should select the general English word maps list as its background. And then we'll allow for up to 1,000 texts being analyzed. From that decision also follows that we will see the full data for all our 456 documents, and we'll see at least the 7,500 first words in each of the documents. Now, it might be that we have more words than this, but I wouldn't expect so. So this is a good long list of tokens that we're having here. So we'll submit this for analysis. And right now the texts are being read, and we should have a spreadsheet in our computer in a few minutes, where we can read all we need to know about the total vocabulary. And actually, here we have it. So we'll open this spreadsheet. Quite a big document. We can see here that 456 texts have been analyzed. And we want to see the results. They are here. And here you go. Now, there are many details here for us to consider. So the first thing I'll do is I'll make the document filterable. So I'm going to apply some filters now. In the first column, we have the actual words. We can go down to the end and see that, yes, we did actually hit the ceiling here. We have a full 7,500 words here, but apparently the list would have been even longer if we had allowed for that. But we decided to implement a ceiling of 7,500 words. What we see here in column 2 is that the actual occurrence of the most frequent word is 316 times. So that's the actual count across all the documents of the word the. And this third column just confirms what we already expected, that the most frequent word would be in the first row here. So that's what we have, the number 1. This is comparable with our background list, or the so-called corpus frequency or corpus vocabulary list. In the general list, it appears the word the is not ranked number 1, but ranked number 3. So already now we can see a little bit of difference between our texts and what you could perhaps call average English. In the next column, we have something that will allow us to really take out some groups of words that we might want to put under some more scrutiny. For example, we can decide to say, well, I'm only interested in words that are less frequent than rank number 250,000 in general English. So I select what we call Roman 7 here, and immediately we discover that the word grayling, which is very infrequent in average English, actually occurs 554 times in these texts. For that reason, it becomes ranked number 951. And for that reason, it was included in our list. But actually, in average English, it's much more infrequent. We can also see the length of the words. We can see the percentage of texts where particular words occur. For example, we notice that grayling, although it does occur quite frequently in all the texts, it actually is only present in 1 out of 20 texts, so the text's presence percentage is 5%. We can compare this with the word job seeker, which is less frequent, but does occur in 12% of all the texts. We can also see in which of the texts the words actually occur. For example, job seeker does not occur in this first text here. And you can basically pursue any of the words that you're interested in and find out more information about the pattern of presence or absence of the particular words. This document contains lots and lots of information about all the texts you are analyzing, and I invite you to try out on your own. Make a project, upload some documents that belong to the project, and see how easy it is for you to get overview of the vocabulary using the frequency report. And let's just show you again where the frequency report actually occurs. It's down here at the bottom. And best of luck trying it out. Thanks for watching, and see you back soon.